Hello guys, this is Anuj from GATELIGHT Academy, and this is the lecture 2 of elementary signal of the chapter Introduction to Signals. And in this lecture we will learn 4 elementary signals, that are unit step function, unit ramp function, unit parabolic function and signum function. So we will learn all of these 4 function in details. So moving to the first function, that is unit step function, then it can be of both type, that is continuous type and discrete type. The continuous type unit step function is denoted by u of t, and the discrete time unit step function or unit step sequence is denoted by u of n. Now moving to continuous time unit step function, then the continuous time unit step function is also called Heaviside unit function. And the continuous time unit step function is defined by u of t is equal to 1 for all t greater than 0, and it is 0 for all t less than 0. That means for all the positive value of time, for all the positive time it is 1, and for all the negative value of time it is 0. When we plot it graphically, then for all t greater than 0 it is 1. So it is 1 for all the t greater than 0, and for all t less than 0 it is 0. So what is the value at time t is equal to 0? At time t is equal to 0, it is indeterministic. The function ut is discontinuous at time t is equal to 0, and at that point the value of ut is not known. However, we can find the average value of that ut at t is equal to 0. How can we find that? For this we use the basic property of the function, that for any point, any time, any x, the value of the function is the average of the values adjacent to it. That means if we want to find the average of ut at t is equal to 0, then u of 0 will be equal to u of 0 minus plus u of 0 plus divided by 2. This is average. Now u of 0 minus, we know that 0 minus, that means negative, and for negative number the ut is 0. For negative it is 0. So u of 0 minus is 0, and u of 0 plus is, that means t greater than 0. So it, the ut at t is greater than 0, the value of ut is 1, that will be 1. So 0 plus 1 divided by 2, that is 1 by 2. In this way the average value of u of 0 is equal to half. However, if we find the u of 0, the what is the value of u of 0, then it will be indeterministic, but the average value will be half. Now we move to some properties of continuous time unit step function. Then first property is that the unit step signal can be represented as an integral of weighted shifted impulse. What is shifted impulse? This is the shifted impulse, because we know the impulse is written as the del of t. When we shift it, then it will be plus minus tau, where it will in can be minus tau or plus tau. Here we, I have taken it minus tau. So this is the shifted impulse, del of t minus tau. So the ut can also be written as the integration 0 to infinity del of t minus tau dt. In this way we can say that unit step function is integration of unit impulse function. How can it will be proved? For proof of this function we will use one theorem, one property of unit impulse function that we have already learned in last video lecture. In last video lecture we have learned shifting property. According to the shifting property of unit impulse function, any function x of t can be written as integration minus infinity to infinity x of tau del of t minus tau dt. We have learned this property. In this property, if we replace x t by ut, x by u, then ut will be equal to minus infinity to infinity x of tau del of t minus tau d tau. Now del of t minus tau into u tau. Now this u tau can be divided into two parts. First is minus infinity to zero u tau del of t minus tau d tau, and another is 0 to infinity u tau del of t minus tau d tau. Minus infinity to 0, that interval is negative, and for negative interval the u tau is 0. The value of unit step function for negative value is 0. Hence 0 into del t minus tau, that will be 0, and the integral of 0 will be 0. But in case of 0 to infinity, that is positive number, for positive time unit step function is 1. So this will be equal to 1 into del t minus tau d tau. We have used the property that u of tau will be equal to 1 for tau greater than 0 and 0 for tau less than 0. Now 1 into del t minus tau, that will be del of t minus tau d tau, 0 to infinity. Here tau can also be replaced by t. Equating the left hand side and right hand side, then ut is equal to 0 to infinity del t minus tau dt. So it is a important expression. Remember this. Moving to the second property, that is a scaling property. According to this property, when we scale the time t by a constant a, then the resultant will be itself ut. That means, for example, u of 2t will be same as u of t, u of 3t will be same as u of t. But it is only for a greater than 0. U of minus t is not equal to u of t. This a is greater than 0. Here when we take a negative, then it is not equal to ut. So this happens only when a is greater than 0. How can it will be proved? For proof of this expression, we take the definition. Ut is equal to 1 for all t greater than 0 and 0 for all t less than 0. So u of a t, we are replacing t by a t. So this will be here 1 and 0, but t will be replaced by a t. Now a t is greater than 0, then here t greater than 0 by a. We have taken this a in the division. Here also it is a t. So here also t is less than 0 by a. This implies that t greater than 0, and this implies that t less than 0. So from here u of a t is equal to 1 for all t greater than 0 and 0 for all t less than 0. And what is this? This is the definition of u of t. From here we can say that u of a t is equal to u of t. So this is a important property, that when we scale the time t by a, a positive time, positive quantity a, then the function will be remain unit step function. Now we find the equivalent of u a t minus t naught. What will be the equivalent? Then for this we can write a outside. A will be common, then a into t minus t naught by a, and we will know that u of a t is equal to u of t. We have just stated above. So this will be also equal to u of t minus t minus t naught by a. From here we can state that u of a t minus t naught is equal to u of t minus t naught by a. From this expression we are finding one question. So u of 2t minus 4 is also equal to, So u of 2t minus 4, then 2 can be taken outside. So 2 will be taken outside, then what will be the inside? T minus 2. And u of 2t will be equal to u of t. So ignoring the 2, u of t minus 2. So the answer is u of t minus 2. Moving to the third property. In third property, if we take a power of ut, when we take power like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, any power of ut, then it will be remain ut. That means, for example, if we take ut to the power 4, then the function will be remain ut. Let's take ut to the power 173, then the function will be remain ut. This is not only happens for the ut, it also happens for the shifted ut. Here ut is shifted by t naught. So u of t minus t naught whole to the power k is same as equal to u of t minus t naught. So both of these two are important expression and you should memorize this. Now simplify u of at minus t naught to the power n. How can it will be solved? For solving this, we will use both property number 2 that we have already learned and this property number 3. So according to property number 3, u of at minus t naught whole to the power n, this will be same as u of at minus t naught. Now u of at minus t naught can also be written as u into a taken outside t minus t naught by a. And we have just learned in the second property that u of at is equal to u of t. So we can ignore a and the answer is u of t minus t naught by a. So this is the answer. Moving to one question, that u of 2t minus 2 whole to the power 4 is equal to. Then we know that any power of unit step function is the same. Unit step function, whether either shifted or not. So 2t minus 2. Now 2 can be taken outside. So 2 into 2 minus 1. Hence, since u of at is same ut, so 2 can be ignored. So this is u of t minus 1. So the answer is u of t minus 1. Moving to discrete time case, then discrete time unit step signal sequences are denoted by u of n, and u of n similar to the u of t, it is defined as 1 for all n greater than equal to 0. Here you can notice that this is equal to. In continuous time case, there is no any value at t is equal to 0. But in the case of discrete time, at n is equal to 0, the value of the function is 1. So the function value is 1 at n greater than equal to 0, and it is 0 for all n less than 0. When we plot it graphically, then for all n greater than 0 or equal greater than or equal to 0, it is 1. But for all negative n, that is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, that means n less than 0, it is equal to 0. So how can you write it in different way? One can be written it in this way. That means, let take this one, then plus at 0, it is 1, at 1, take 1. At 2, take 2, take 1. In this way, when we add all the graphs, then finally we will get this graph. And what is this? This is graph of del of n. This is graph of del of n minus 1. This is graph of del of n minus 2. We have already learned unit impulse function and the graph of the unit impulse function. Unit impulse can discrete time unit impulse sequences. So in this way, we can say that u of n can be written as del of n plus del of n minus 1 plus del of n minus 2 plus so on. So it can also be written as summation del n minus k. K is equal to 0 to infinity. That is the property number first. It is the analogous to the property number first of continuous time unit step function. In that, we have stated that the unit step function is integration of weighted shifted impulse functions. Here, in case of discrete, the integration is replaced by is analogous to summation. So summation of weighted shifted impulse function. When we talk about the second property that we have learned in the continuous time, that was shifting property. In shifting property, we have learned that u of at is equal to u of t. So do this property also holds true in case of discrete time? That is, u of an is equal to u of n. Is this correct? I want the answer from you. So put the answer in the comment box. And I want to know if you are learning it or not. Okay. So put it in the comment box. That u of n is equal to u of n, it is true or not. If it is correct, then why? And if it is not correct, then why? Now moving to another elementary signal, that is unit ramp function. Unit ramp function, it can also be of both type, continuous time and discrete time. And the continuous time unit ramp function is denoted by r of t. And the discrete time unit ramp sequence can be denoted by r of n. And how can it will be defined? The continuous time unit ramp function is defined by r of t is equal to t for t greater than equal to 0 and 0 for all t less than 0. In case of ut, here was 1, but in case of rt, it is t. When we draw it graphically, then graphically for all t greater than equal to 0, rt is equal to t. So it is in the form of y is equal to x, and we will know that y is equal to x is a straight line passing through origin with a slope 1. So for time t greater than equal to 0, rt is a straight line passing through the origin with a slope 1, and for all t less than 0, it is 0. When we talk about the discrete time, then in discrete time t is replaced by n. So r of n is equal to n for n greater than equal to 0, and it is 0 for n less than 0. Plotting it in the graph, at 0 it is 0, at 1 it is 1, at 2 is equal to 2, at 3 is equal to 3, at 4 is equal to 4, and so on. But for negative, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, it is 0. So this is the basic about the unit ramp function. Now, can we denote rt or rn, that means unit ramp function, in the form of unit step function or not? Yes, we can. How? Let we take the definition of unit step function. Unit step function is equal to 1 for all t greater than equal to all t greater than 0 and 0 at all t less than 0. Now multiply this t by ut. So t of ut is equal to, here 1 will multiply by t for all t greater than 0, and here 0 will multiply by t because we have multiplied the function by t. So all the value will also multiply by t for all t less than 0. What is this? This is t into ut is equal to t for all t less greater than 0, and 0 into t, that means 0 for all t less than 0. And what is this? This is rt, unit ramp function. So in this way we can say that unit ramp function can also be written as t of ut. So it is one of the important expression, and you should always take it in your mind. Similarly, in case of discrete time, then u of n is equal to 1 for all n greater than equal to 0 and 0 for all n less than 0. Now multiplied un by n, n into un, that will be equal to n into 1 for all n greater than equal to 0 and n into 0 for all n less than 0. What is this? N into 1, that will be n for all n greater than equal to 0, n into 0, that will be 0 for all n less than 0. And what is this? This is the definition of R of n. So from here we can say that n into un is equal to R of n. In general, this is the case of RT and RN. In general, let for t greater than 0 there is some value, in place of 1 there is some values, or for t less than 0 there is no value, that is 0. Let, in case, take one example. Let xt is equal to some yt for all t greater than 0, and it is 0 for all t less than 0. Then how can we write it in the form of ut? We can write it in the form of ut as x of t is equal to y of t into u of t. This is the simplified expression. In place of two expression, I am simplifying is into one expression. This expression is equivalent to this expression. How? At ut is 1 at t greater than 0. So for t greater than 0, this value will be yt into 1, that will be yt. And for t less than 0, ut is 0. So yt into 0 is equal to 0. So xt will be 0 for t less than 0. In this, any function xt, for which for t greater than 0 there is a function given, but for t less than 0 the function value is 0, then that function xt can be written as the function that is for the t greater than 0 multiplied by ut. For example, let xt is equal to sin t for t greater than 0, and it is 0 for t less than 0. This is an example. Then xt can also be written as sin t into ut. That this is the function. However, this is valid only for t greater than 0 and t less than 0. What happens but when there is t greater than some constant? Then in that case, take one example. Xt is equal to sin t for t greater than, say, 2. Okay, and 0 for all t less than 2. In this case, this expression can be simplified as xt is equal to sin t into u of t, but in place of only t we will write t minus 2, because it is t greater than 2. So in place of ut it will be replaced by u of t minus 2. And this concept is very important, because this concept is going to be used many time in signal and system topic. So keep it in your mind. Now we will learn what is the relation between del t, ut and rt. Then the relation is that we have already learned all the properties. So we have just remembering all the properties back, that when we integrate the del t, when we integrate the unit impulse function, then what we get? We get unit step function. And when we integrate the unit step function, then we get unit ramp function. And what happens when we integrate the unit ramp function? Then we get unit parabolic function. We haven't learned the unit parabolic function. After this slide we will learn the unit parabolic function, so just wait. Now in inverse, this is integration. In reverse, when we differentiate dy dt, so when we differentiate parabolic function, then we get ramp function. And when we differentiate ramp function, then we get unit, then we get a step function, and when we differentiate a step function, then we get impulse function. So in short, dy dt ut is equal to del t, dy dt rt is equal to ut, and dy dt pt is equal to rt. This expression can also be written as d square pt by dt is equal to ut, because rt can also be written as dy dt of pt. So put this dy dt of pt here, then what will happen? D square pt by dt. So ut is also ut is second differentiation of parabolic function. What is the relationship between unit impulse function and unit parabolic function? Then unit impulse function is third derivative of parabolic function. Unit impulse function is second derivative of unit ramp function. This is the relationship. The similar is the relationship between the del of n, u of n, r of n. We have already learned that what is integration in the continuous time? It is summation in the discrete time. And what is the differentiation in the continuous time? It is the difference in the discrete time. So when we take the summation of del n, then we get u of n, and when we get summation of u n, then we get r of n, and then we get summation of r n, then we get p of n. Similarly, when we get first difference p of n minus p of n minus 1, then we get r of n. When we take the first difference r of n minus r of n minus 1, then we get unit a step sequence. When we take first difference of unit a step sequence, that is u of n minus u of n minus 1, then we get del of n. However, don't take it as summation del of n is equal to u of n. Don't take like this. Take with some limit. Let this is k minus k, n is equal to minus infinity to infinity, then this will be equal to 1. We have already learned the definition. This is not equal to un, this is equal to 1. Okay, so what is un? Un can be written as del of n minus k, for k is equal to 0 to infinity. This is un. Similarly, del summation k is equal to 0 to infinity u of n minus k, that is equal to rn. And summation k is equal to 0 to infinity r of n minus k, this is equal to pn. So summation of del is u, summation of u is r, summation of r is p, and the first difference of p is r, first difference of r is u, and first difference of u is del. So these are the relationship between the continuous type, unit step, unit impulse, unit rank, and also discrete time, unit impulse, unit step, and unit ramp, and also the unit parabolic. So without wasting time, we learn the unit parabolic signals. Then unit parabolic function signals can also be of both types, continuous type and discrete time. Continuous type is denoted by pt, and the discrete type is denoted by pn. And the definition of the continuous time is pt is equal to t square by 2. We know that rt, the unit ramp function, that is t, rt is t for t greater than 0. Now since pt is integration of rt, that means unit parabolic is integration of unit ramp. So when we integrate t with dt, what we get? When we integrate t with dt, what we get? We get t square by 2. That is why pt is equal to t square by 2 for t greater than 0 and 0 for t less than 0. Now if we want to plot it graphically, then pt is equal to t square by 2. So it is like y is equal to x square by 2, and y is equal to x square by 2, it is a parabola, it's equation of parabola. So for t greater than 0, the graph is like a parabola, like y is equal to x square by 2, and for t less than equal to for t less than 0, it is equal to 0. Okay, for similar to discrete time, pn is equal to n square by 2 for n greater than equal to 0, and for n less than 0, it is 0. So for now, p of n is equal to n square by 2. When we take p of 0, then p of 0 is equal to 0 square by 2, that is 0. P of 1, that will equal to 1 square by 2, that is 1 by 2. So at 1, the value is 1 by 2. P of 2, then 2 square by 2, that is 4 by 2, that is 2. So it is 2. P of 3, then 3 square by 2, that is 9 by 4. So this value is 9 by 4. In this way, we plot the graph. But and for all t less than 0, it is equal to 0. So similar to the unit ramp function, what can be the relationship between ut and pt? So from pt, we are noticing that for t greater than 0, it is t square by 2, there is some function, and for t less than 0, it is 0. So as we have learned this in a very descriptive way, we can write pt is also equal to t square by 2, that is the function in the t greater than equal to, multiplied by ut. So the pt is also equal to t square by 2 into ut. This is the relationship between pt and ut. Now t square by 2, we are dividing into two parts, t by 2 into t ut. What is this? This is rt. So pt can also be written as t by 2 into rt. Hence from here we can say that pt is equal to t square by 2 ut, or equal to t by 2 rt. Similarly, in case of discrete time, we are writing it in the direct way. P of n is equal to n square by 2 un, that is also equal to n by 2 into n un, and n of un is rn. So this is also equal to n by 2 rn. We move to the next function, that is signum function. Signum function can also be of type continuous time and discrete time. Discrete continuous time is written as signum t, and the discrete time is signum n. And how can it will be defined? The signum t is defined as 1 for all t greater than 0, and for minus 1 for all t less than 0. What is at t is equal to 0? At t is equal to 0, it is 0. So graphically we can notice that for all t greater than 0, it is 1, and for all t less than equal to 0, it is -1, and at t is equal to 0, it is 0. And in case of discrete time, just replace t by n. Sign of n is 1 for all n greater than 0, 0 for all n is equal to 0, and -1 for all n less than 0. So for all n greater than 0, the value of the function is 1, and for all n less than 0, the value of function is -1, and at n is equal to 0, the value of function is 0. So can we write signum t as a function of ut and u of minus t? Yes, we can write signum t as a function of u of t and u of minus t. We have learned u of t in general. Let xt is a signal or function like this. This is xt, some arbitrary function. Then what will be x of minus t? What will be x of minus t? Then if you have learned the graph very well, then you must know that the x of minus t is always equal to the mirror image of the function x of t with respect to y axis. This is the y axis, so mirror image. That means x of t and x of minus t are mirror image, mirror image with respect to y axis. So when we take the mirror image of this function with respect to what, with respect to y, then what we get this function. So this is x of minus t. What if we take the mirror image with respect to the x-axis? If we take the mirror image with respect to x-axis, then we get minus of xt, not x of minus t, minus of xt. So this function is minus of xt. Now, if we take the mirror image with respect to y-axis of this function, then what we get? Then we get x of minus of xt and mirror image with respect to y-axis, so minus of x of minus t. So this is minus x of minus t. In general, let this is xt, then this is x of minus t, and this is minus of xt, and this will be minus of x of minus t. Okay, so keep it in your mind. Now we take ut and u of minus t, then this is ut. For all t greater than 0, it is 1, and for all t less than 0, it is 0. This is ut. How can we find the u of minus t? For u of minus t, you have to take mirror image with respect to y-axis. So with respect to y-axis, let this is the mirror, then what will be the mirror image? This will be the 1. For all t greater than 0, that will be for t less than 0, and what is for t less than 0? That will be now for t greater than 0. So u of minus t can also be written as 0 for all t greater than 0 and 1 for all t less than 0. This is u of minus t. Now if you want to find minus of ut, then how can you find? You have to take a mirror image with respect to the x-axis. So this is the mirror image. Here this is minus of ut, and if you take the y image with respect to the y-axis of this, then what we get? That means this is minus of u of minus t. In this way we can find all the possible graphs with respect to the u of t. Now let add u of t plus u of minus t. Just notice it, u of t and u of minus t. So u of t is this and u of minus t is like this. For all t less than 0, it is 1, and for all t greater than 0, it is 0. When we add all these, both of these, then what we get? We get that for all t less than 0, it is 0, and it is 0 at all t less than 0, and it is 1 at all t less than 0. When we add this, then for all t less than 0, 0 will add to 1, and what we get? We get 1. So for all t less than 0, it will be 1. Similarly, for t greater than 0, it is 1, and for t greater than 0, it is 0. When we add both of these, then finally we get what? 0 plus 1, 1. So what we are getting? We are getting that for all t, anything, both t less than 0 or t greater than 0, the value of the function is 1. So we can say that u of t plus u of minus t is equal to 1. So this is the important expression, and you should keep it in your mind. Okay. What happen if you take ut minus u minus t? Just notice this. This is ut. Okay, this is ut. And what is minus of u plus t? You are minusing it. So minusing it, this is minus sign. This is minus sign. And this is u of minus t. So for t less than 0, this is for t less than 0. This is t greater than 0, and this is t greater than 0. This is minus sign. Now minusing it, for t less than 0. It is 0 and it is 1. So for t less than 0, 0 minus 1, that will be equal to minus 1. So for t less than 0, the value of the function will be minus 1, because 0 minus 1 is equal to minus 1. And for all t greater than 0, for all t greater than 0, it is 1 and it is 0. So 1 minus 0, that will be equal to 1. So for all t greater than 0, it will be equal to 1. And what we get? We get signum function. Look at this. This is the signum function. So we are getting the signum function. So in this way, we can say that u of t minus u of minus t is equal to signum t. So we come to a important conclusion, and the conclusion is that ut plus u of minus t is equal to 1, and ut minus u of minus t is equal to signum t. We can find two more conclusions also. How? Just add this. If you add this, then what we are getting? This will be cancelled. So 2ut is equal to 1 plus signum t. From here, signum t can be written as 2ut minus 1. So one expression for the signum t can be 2ut minus 1. And if we can also find another expression in terms of u of minus t, how? Just subtract both of these equations. Then what do you get? 2 of u of minus t is equal to 1 minus signum t. So from here, signum t is equal to 1 minus 2 u of minus t. So these are the two expressions. And we have already two expressions more. So these are the four expressions. So remember all the four expressions. And these expressions are ut plus u minus t is equal to 1. And signum t can be written in the four terms like ut plus u minus t, 2ut minus 1, or 1 minus 2u minus t. So keep it in your mind. So this is all in lecture 2. In next lecture, we will continue the elementary signal, and we will learn 5 more elementary signals, and then we will end this chapter, that is elementary signal. So keep watching and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.